We are 4-0. As promised, I have made adjustments. It should not be as easy as it was before. And that kind of worries me a little bit. Because it's nice. It's nice winning. It's nice seeing all the rest of the AFC lose. It's nice to be the cause of that. I've already played the Monarchs. I've already played the Shamrocks. I have yet to play the Orbits, I don't believe. Who was this? So I played four teams. I know one of them was the Nighthawks. The Snowhawks, that was the other one. So we played two predatory birds. And this week we play one of the NFC Souths. So the New York Giants were relocated to the Brazilian Red Dragons. The Rio de Janeiro Red Dragons. And we shall play them. Now, we already did look to do some player contracts. We'll do some more at the end. But I think we already checked. And yes, Kyler Murray outplayed our offense. But Bryce Callahan surely did his work. He put in his stake and claim to it. So we did have one person, like we do every week, at least one person in the weekly awards. Smart thing to do, as always. Managed roster, NFL roster. Let's check out the Red Dragons. Starting with the quarterback, Justin Fields, who is not doing well for me in fantasy. Pick it up, boy. They also have PJ Walker and Kyle Trask. Not bad backups. Kyle Trask deserves more than 60. I mean, a lot of people were thinking he might actually win the starting job over Baker Mayfield, who's doing fantastic, don't get me wrong. But if you're doing fantastic and this other guy is almost going to beat you out, then sounds to me like he should be kind of fantastic too, don't you think? But PJ Walker, someone that I'm hoping his career takes off because he was in the AFL. And it's good to have football in the summer, but they're only going to keep that and develop it if they transition onto the NFL field. For now, as much as they don't want to admit that they are training camp or a developmental league for the NFL, they don't intend to be, but for now, it gets a lot of interconnectivity, mobility, if we can get players from there to the NFL and then do well. So PJ Walker, keep it up, brother. Tony Pollard, so good running back, good quarterback. They also have Rashad White and Tank Bigsby, a great backup. Probably I would put him in over Rashad White. And then Kenny and Ngongu. Do they have a fullback? Yeah, Tank Bigsby. I just said that. Now, Garrett Wilson, wow. I can't be mad because I also have a really good 1-2 punch. But I also have Trey Lance. And then my second wide receiver is not as good. So, Tyler Boyd, Van Jefferson, Khalif Raymond, who's actually on my fantasy football team. And I'm hoping good things from him. Not just for being on the field, but both of my leagues give points and bonuses to kick returners. D.D. Westbrook, I almost want to rename him Russell Wilson Westbrook, but that's a different league. And then Mike Thomas, the one that was on the Bengals, not Michael Thomas, the one that was on the Saints. Dallas Goedert and Josh Oliver and Hunter Long, which I thought Hunter Long was a left tackle, but maybe a converted tight end. But either way, not a bad offense. Do we have something that we can exploit on their line? 79, 81, 70, 79, 75. The outs and the ins. So, let's take another quick look here. Pass block, 83. Run block, 79. So, 83, 79. The run block stood on the out. Run block, 68 on the inside. Run block, 71, 78, and 68. They are not a good run blocking team. So that means I don't have to blitz to stop the run. Sometimes we do that. We fill gaps to prevent running lanes from opening up. I don't have to do that here. I should be able to get through. Zach Sealer, 79. Felix Anudike Uzoma. Uzoma? Uzoma? That's the same spelling as Uzoma, right? The tight end. Tecmo's McKinley, I thought he was a safety. And then Khalid Kareem, so mid-70s. Devon Godchow. Joey Bosa, there we go. The demon of their defense. And Bobby Okereke over there. Oh, Khalil Mack. I'm always surprised by how old he is. But that's because I've been a fan for a long time. I'm a huge Raiders fan. And then when he went from there to the Bears, kind of a Bears fan if you didn't know. I hope that showed with the 54. But it says he's injured, and I wanted to see what his injury was, but I'm going to have to go to something else entirely just to see it. But he is a superstar. And Alex Anzalone is not a bad one, but I see the injury, and I just wondered if he's going to be in this game or not. Cornerback, Sauce Gardner, goodness gracious. Kader Kahoo, I don't know. Mike Jackson Sr., Benjamin St. Juice, and Danny Johnson, and then Samuel Womack. Okay. Free safety, Xavier Woods. Not bad. Good value, especially at the age, probably later on in the draft. PJ Williams, so if we get a they got a PJ Walker and a PJ Williams. Adrian Amos, again, respectable. Former Bear. Value for the age, probably going to look for a replacement in the draft. He might even retire this year, you know. And then Joey Sly is their kicker. Ryan Stonehouse is their punter. And you know what else we're going to do? We're going to take a quick peek ski and see if any of our Sentinels who had a hidden trait have become unhidden, discovered. I guess the fastest way to do this would be put my entire roster and then go by age. Logan Thompson's a rookie? Ooh, that's... He has no traits, so huh? He's normal, though. That's messed up. He had an amazing offseason. I hate how I have to reset the age bracket every time. Javion Hawkins, you're here. Eric Gray, trading you at the deadline. Bush here, Trey Lance. Has to be at least star, right? Wow. You've earned that, though. I am mad at that one. I'm disappointed because you're on my Madden team, but you don't deserve it. I can imagine that conversation in the room. So what about this bust who just got traded from where he was, which was a first round top 10 pick, to the only league that would do it above a fourth, gave him a third or something. Normal death. Okay, good. Still hidden. 70 more snaps. We might get that this game. Plus, he is one of our focus players, so I think that eats away a little bit at that. Is there anybody else that we were interested in? Because it's got to be a rookie. I think I don't need rookies above that age. I could have sworn I had two hidden development players. Maybe this game. But we saw what they have. Their run game is... They could have two elite running backs. And that's not going to do anything. Because we have a D-line better than their O-line. And it doesn't even have to be that good. So what do we want to defend from just... If they can't run it, and so we're going to be in coverage more often. Just like with Lamar Jackson, that worked. We're at 100, full pads. I definitely want... For free safety, we'll do starter because Logan Ryan is hurt anyway. Adrian Phillips, I'm not really worried about. Bryce Callahan, I'm not really worried about. Crossen, I am. Harrison, I am. Adoree Jackson, Bradley Roby, and Isaiah Rogers Sr. I'm going to split that up between them. So that's split here. Obviously, Pete Werner. Gardeck had a play this past weekend. But I'm looking at, is there anyone specifically that I want deeper in the depth chart to develop? So obviously not left end. We have injuries there anyway. Scoobity Dorf 3, the third. And Turner and Poston. That's fine there. Al Woods is injured. So give it all to the starters. And I think we're good. Good top threat, PJ Walker. Now, Bosa is out. And I didn't see a lot of scary things from their D-line. So are we going to run it some more? You betcha. They're so close. They're so similar. They do more zone blitzes. So inside zones. We run a lot of those. We have a lot of those in the playbook. So we'll go ahead and do a few of those. Here, I want to split just because I don't want to get any of my O-linemen hurt. Both Humphrey and Hainsey, my starter and my backup center, both injured out last game. So I'm glad to see them back on the field, but goodness gracious, that's scary. For tight end, give it all to Kincaid. If he's at 100%, take it. There's only one fullback, so I'm not going to do that. Halfbacks, split. I don't want anybody hurt. We're already down people. Wide receivers, backups. Let's not fatigue any more than necessary our best receivers. Okay. Team profile, so let's take a look at the game plan. Let's start with our head coach. Our head coach, he said, you look at the past few games, and I keep offering no sacks allowed. Now, I know that we get sacked every week, but maybe this will be our week. That's not how we get franchise points, man. Winning the turnover battle is guaranteed at this point. I want a challenge. I want to score. I want to destroy them. And with that line in our running game, we can do it. Our offensive coordinator says 350 yards. Deal. I've kept on doubting you, and we keep meeting your expectations. I trust you. Allow 30 points or less? Deal. You know something I don't. Sack the quarterback 5 times. We have yet to get a sack on the season. I think we have 1 sack all season. I'd rather try to get 200 rushing yards. Between Trey Lance, the thing is, we don't have Josh Jacobs. If we had Josh Jacobs, this would be too easy as well. But 4-3 turnovers, I think we can do that. So let's do that. Man, 5 rushing touchdowns for 10 franchise points, that's amazing. All right, Dalton Kincaid. I thought you would also get, I thought it would also help us towards uncovering his development. Catch passes. Okay. Score 3-7 in the Browns Pittsburgh game. I called for it when I broke backwards. Come on, man. I didn't even see the 400 there. I could have went for that. Whoa! Dude! Didn't get the bonus there. I can't believe I got shivved like that. Okay, we got bronze. If we get silver, we're out. I mean... Oh, come on! We're gonna try. We need at least silver, and that shiv, man, that shiv. And we were so close. We were one catch away. You know, one not getting shoved away. More important thing to do though is catch the ball. I say that, and then. Swap multiplier, let's go. Yes! Alright, we're definitely getting silver. Ooh, that was close. Can we go for gold? I see the 500. I'd rather do that though. Here, all we need to do is catch the ball, so we'll see what he gives us. Oh, we got gold! No. We're good. We'll take that. Woo! Alright, still 3-7, it looks like. Continue. I really wish that counted towards the snaps, man. Christian Barmore, we already know what we're going to do. Three shots, three gold. How you doing? Oh yeah, still 3-7. Oh. Hola! Bienvenido. Muchas gracias. I wonder if we're going to get the week one Giants or the week two Giants. But this one... Always trench... No, Jason Dak. You want to know why? Because it's I don't want to say guaranteed goal, but it is. And we just want to move on to the game, you know? EA. Whatever, it kills time. And I'd rather it be the early... I was going to say, because of the multiplier, I'd rather it be the early one. The one time he doesn't decide to go through the middle. Okay. Yeah, with the fumble, because I'm done. I'm done now. All the points. I want them all. I want them all! All of them. Give me. And is that J.B. Hawkins? Mind you, Hawkins has a lower overall than Eric Gray. I don't care. He's proven himself, and that's more important to me. And Eric Gray really just does not. He plays to his overall. Davian Hawkins, on the other hand, this is what I get for saying it's a gimmick. It's because of those. He makes these new decisions. I'm almost proud of him. We're doing that again. This is a new feeling. Pride in someone else. Too bad it's overshadowed by this blinding rage! That's better. What is this? I like the kid, but Javion Hawkins don't got that kind of stiff arm. Done and over with. Come on. I was hitting R1 to see if the script would work. I still have yet to get one of those. I can't believe I'm gonna do this again. I'm only consistently getting 120,000, and here I am getting less than 20,000. But we're at silver. Maybe one more. I mean, it depends on gold. Whoa, what? It says zeros on the timer. I'll take that extra shot, though. Gold. That being said, practice goblin. Stay away. Okay, defense. Good. Offense. Come on. I like it. I like it. We got a good game plan. Before the game, let's do some upgrades and then get into it. Javion Hawkins, I mean, I've never even seen his ratings. He just answers the call. He's got speed. And he's a backup. I don't expect him to have elite everything, but I do appreciate all the greens. The carrying especially, although the carrying does need to go up, and the break tackle needs to go up. So carrying, break tackle, can we get them both in one package? Well, here's break tackle. Break tackle plus two. Awesome. Tyrell Dodson with two, you can be done by the computer. Jamar Chase. What else is left to say? Maybe elusive for carrying. His juke move, bring that up to the 90s. But everything else is perfect. Yeah, ball carrier, vision, juke move, break tackle. Plus, it is our scheme. Ball carrier vision, break tackle, catch in traffic, deep route, juke move, medium route, short route. Okay. Whatever your contract is, we will honor it. Javon Holland, we've been focusing on him. He's got good speed and acceleration. His tackle and his pursuit are decent. His man coverage is okay. I want his play rep to go up. And that's it. I just want him to be a... My safeties, I want smart safeties. So play recognition is there. Play recognition is there. All three of them. Zone has the team scheme. His zone's already 87. His man is 83. So to tackle, which one has tackle? Play recognition, tackle, zone cuff. Goodness gracious, we'll take it. Adoree Jackson. Oh no, that's next. Deron Payne. If you have that much strength, you need power moves. All I want to do is make you the most powerful. Last franchise, I had Vita Vea. And Vita Vea didn't do much for the stats. 99. Does that say plus one strength? When it rains, it is glorious. 96 strength. Now, I forgot. I didn't even see the other ones. I was so happy about that. Adoree Jackson, our leading corner. Although, getting up there in age, you know. See, I feel like the ones that I like, that where they're like, oh, Khalil Mack is 32 years old. How? And I forget Adoree Jackson. When I like them so much, I feel like I like them because they've done so much in the league. Whatever. Speed 93, man coverage and zone coverage are both in the 80s. Play rec needs to go up. And then aside from that, what's tackle? 53. Focus on tackle. Focus on tackle. Hopefully get a play rec. Wow. Agility, awareness, man coverage, play rec, and press. Yes. Braden Smith, our right tackle. Solid everywhere. That pass block finesse, I want to get into the 80s, and then I want to improve his impact block. So let's get some finesse. Got it. And then impact blocking next time around. Adrian Phillips. 31 years old, probably the last year with us. So with, you know what? We're not going to develop his man. So let's either do zone, because he's already good at zone, make it a little bit better, or do run support because it's our team scheme. Cool. Zone still went up. Awesome. That power is at 79. I don't even have to look. I just want that up. Now that's up to 80. Dalton Kincaid, man. All we want to know is if you're a star, or a superstar or an X Factor. I don't know. Okay, I don't know. He's just amazing for us. Now, like I last time, I focused on his blocking because in the long run, he needs to be a good blocker. I need my tight ends to block. But he's doing well enough that I want to focus on him for our Offensive Rookie of the Year. Awareness. Catching. Wow. Lead block. Pass block. Pass block. Run block. Run block. Short route. Goodness gracious. Alright. Almost done. Pete Werner. Nick Chubb rush for 20 yards. Nice. He's on my team. I mean, he's fun to... It's changing direction. If that was something we could focus on, that would be great. Just because if I'm going to be usering him, that helps me more than anything else. His zone is at 69, which is nice. Let's get it better than that. Yeah. Come on, zone. Got it. Christian Barmore. Left end. Strength is 88. So, either way, we need the block sheds to go up. He's green on everything else. He's got toughness and pursuit. For that, I want to go ahead and get at least one speed rusher point. Yeah, pursuit is good. Finesse moves good. But if he breaks the line, I want it to be faster so that he could do something with the strength he has. Devin Lloyd. My middle linebacker is like the quarterback of that defense. So I need him. I need that play rep to be a lot better, and that zone coverage to be a lot better. Let's focus on the play rep for now. Team scheme didn't work out this time so much. Pursuit and tackle. I'm happy. Not too worried about Mike Edwards, but Tyus Bowser might be with us for a while. I mean, normal development, if we draft somebody who turns out to be a star or a superstar even, then we'll definitely still have Tyus Bowser in the backup. But speed does need to go up. Block shed needs to go up. Zone is terrible. If his tackle is less than 75, it's at 75 now. We're doing that. Tackle, hopefully a pursuit, a block shed maybe. Block shed, tackle, and zone. You just speak well into the universe. I'm going to trust the computer with the rest except for, as you could probably guess, Trey Lance. He doesn't have a rocket arm. Like, it says 92, but it's just not, it's not snapping. It's not quick. Plus, we do a lot of throwing on the run that he could be better. And under pressure. So, scrambler, improviser. His improviser is so low that it's going to be a combination of those two things, so they both need to get better. Throw accuracy, mid, short, under pressure, very important in awareness. The rest, upgrade all. Yep. I have a feeling we're going to get a lot of franchise points. It's time for the drip drip. drip, drip. Always start off with the CPU uniforms. White shirt, red pants, red socks. I said we're already on red socks, okay. Do we have blue pants? Nah, we'll do black. Okay. Dallas Goedert, Sauce Gardner, and the injured Joey Bosa. Hopefully 70 snaps and we can get Dalton Kincaid's development. We are at home. 4-0, crowd loves us. Bobby Okereke, 9 tackles last week. You know, between Trey Lance and Dorian Tompkins, we have TLDR. So that shirt probably sold out. Home crowd. Home crowd loves us. Away team, Brian Daboll, coming all the way from Rio de Janeiro. Justin Fields, we are going to contain him. That's his only weapon. I mean, look at what happened last week. DJ Moore, 3 passes in 1 drive, did excellent with all of them. Then they stop passing it to him and they wonder why they lose. Now the screen pass that was picked off in return for 6 points, was that because of the athletic D lineman or because it just wasn't executed? Those helmets are so much better than what they were. Let's see what Justin Fields' numbers are for the year. I hope they tell us his rushing stats. 2-0 touchdown to interception ratio at this point in the season means he's a runner. So, option defense, focus on the quarterback. Tackling, you know me. And then, ball in the air, swap. And then cornerback matchups, we'll do by speed and see if we have to change that. We might have to change that sooner than we would like. But Pete Werner focusing on the halfback. Tony Pollard, -1. Tackle for a loss. Bring in the pain. 3 wide receivers. Let's do a cover 9 show 2. We'll show blitz. I like this. Touch up, bounce, drag. Oh no! That's how they're gonna beat us. That's how they're gonna beat us. We need a spy at all times. So here we'll do. We knew it was a passing play. At least we guessed right on that. Yeah, their running isn't going to get them anything. Their line isn't good enough. 2 more weeks, Josh Jacobs will be back. Woo! Looked like a DDT in progress. 3rd and 5. We're going to do cover 3. I'm going to have Turner, spy, and Barmore hit up out. Oh, that.
Access denied.
Good swat! Good swat. Now, I tried to get there in time to do a user pick. I thought he was open. I'm not going to lie. I thought he was open. Nah. How about our stats? Through four games, Trey Lance, 1,000 yards, 10-2. Not bad. Not bad. As always, we start with a run. Numbers are on the right. Come on. Come on, Damien. Damien, you had a touchdown. Josh Jacobs would have had a touchdown. We miss you, Josh Jacobs. You know, Jadeon Hawkins stepping in as a backup, thank you for your service. But let's not get it twisted. Let's just go another way. They were with Chase the whole time. Circle was double covered. I'm good with that. That would have been a touchdown with Josh Jacobs. I would love to set the tempo. Oh, Patrick Ricard. Jean-Luc Ricard. So we've got numbers on the left if I knew. Okay. Oh yeah, here we go. Ooh. We were able to set one tackle. Three came back there, but only one of us, one of them actually touched me. Sauce Gardner came up. I see Jones, I see Chase. Amazing, amazing, amazing. I was going to just let that first tackle take us down. But that, the truck, that was me. Keep your number one happy. Keep your number one happy if you want him to stay. What is our game plan? Run on the inside? They like to do a lot of zone. I think this is good. We don't have the numbers. We'll take what they gave us. 110 rushing yards last week with Jadeon Hawkins. Two touchdowns. One of them was one of those long breaker runs that we would love to see more of. All right, we're going to do a dagger across. So again, watching Jones, watching Chase. We'll see what happens with... Amazing. What? What is happening? What just happened? I know it's Sauce Gardner then, but wow. So first of all, good catch. The ground caused the fumble, man. The ground caused the fumble, and I can't even challenge it. Oh my goodness, Mike Ditka, football lord. Oh, they're challenging that fumble? Come on. Like, EA can only process so many things at once. But we have the ball back. So they thought that their fumble wasn't a fumble. So that reversed the original decision of a fumble. Get down! That worked in our favor. That was gut-wrenching to be doing so well. I think when you make the decision to throw it away, and it's the right decision and it's a smart decision, you need to reward yourself by saying that wasn't a pick. And if it was a pick, then they might have scored. And if they scored, they would have had momentum. And if they had momentum, then the game was theirs to begin with. So instead of losing the game in the first minute, you keep it fun. You keep it competitive. That's why I don't like playing you mutt people. Stun kick it to my fullback and tight end. Like, play the game, man. I'm watching you, Justin. I'm watching you, Justin! I don't know who recovered it, but I'm watching you, Justin. There's some weird Undertaker hand sign. I don't think we recovered it. I know he fumbled it. I hit him. I did a cut stick, too. Was that Werner? Werner comes in with the reset. Yeah! This is a good time for a play action. That's what you get. That's what you get for one. Trey Lance. What Justin did was he tried to manipulate the EA algorithm. He's a Russian quarterback. Everybody was covered. But he didn't realize that we game plan. I just wanted to go out of bounds and stay safe. Jonu! Titan and a Patriot. Okay, let's do a counter. Block picked up, outside, cut in. Ooh. Forearm shiver to the face. No thanks, I prefer to shave with a razor. Says we have numbers on the right. I don't think we do. We're going to the left. Don Kincaid is hurt. Okay. I'm gonna do a wheel switch. I'm looking at Khalil Shakir. I'm looking at John. Come on. Come on, Dalton. Dalton, come back. Dalton, come back! You can blame it all on me. It wasn't even part of the play. Abdominal tear. Jonnu Smith paid the NFL script writers is what he did. It's like, I need more time. No one's going to pay me if I don't get more time to show what I can do. I'm so invested in Dalton Kincaid. Goodness gracious. Pete Werner, where was this during your breakout session? I'm happy. I'm happy. I really am. I'm just. So caught up on their O-line. Their terrible, terrible O-line. Drag him down. There was nobody behind him, but I didn't want to risk even a cut stick. I just did a conservative tackle animation. Let's go with Three wide receivers, we'll do the zone. You know what? No. Let's put a little pressure. First of all, I'm holding right to travel with the running back. But no, our animation says this way. Like, did you mean down? No, Dora the Explorer. .30 to .60, .25 to .50. So we're double their production. It says we're not letting Justin Fields run. You have to pass it up. I mean, you can. You're saying you have to. I like this formation, but I know that my guy's going to tire out. I felt the slant move, and I tried to go with it. They're like, sure. I feel like they button red and moved up instead. Okay, three tight ends this time. I only have one nickel formation. Three tight ends. Blitz. Bryce Callahan is on the inside tight end, who usually doesn't have working. Ooh! Tyus Bowser! Let's get them sack numbers up, boy. Three wide receivers this time, Sam Blitz. Again, Tyus Bowser, except I'll be focusing on the tight end here that's lined out wide. Let's go! 4th and 21. Kick the dang ball. Let's get that time in. I got the timing right, but I was looking at the wrong player and I didn't hit the dump. Twice this season so far, I've gone through the line. One of them, I thought I should. Did he miss it? How do you miss it from... Oh, that's a 50-something yard kick, I suppose. Man. So I did a low throw, because I knew he was going to pass him, but I wanted him to crash in a little bit. I was worried that if I threw it too hard, too high, that he would have been able to catch up with the ball at that point. My God. Invest in your O-line, people. Invest in your O-line. Johnny is my out, but I want to see what Chase has here. The middle linebacker took, I knew he was going to take too long to get across. I always worry about those catches where it's a catch and then it's a boom boom play and they drop it, like it gets knocked out. Not too worried that time. This all started with that Justin Fields fumble. -10 The Browns over the Pittsburgh Steelers. What? That was almost crushing. I would have felt bad. Three tight ends again. See, I like the cover sky here because it forces our safeties up. Just follow the running back. Follow the running back. Play smart. That's all we need. I'm not threatened by Justin Fields. He's got two good wide receivers. They'll catch the ball if he throws it medium or short. So just don't give him the time. Just don't give him the time. Bully him. It feels good. I wouldn't be doing this if I didn't have a lead. Boswell, 65 yards. Jay Ford, right guard, 29, 4 yards. These people. Yeah, we out here. Another. Who got hurt? It looked like a dragon. I noticed that only one player can get injured per play. I've never, in all my years of Madden, not just this one. Never had more than one injury at a time. These are all play actions. Goodness gracious. Sometimes I'd be calling play action plays and I'm like, I don't want to do a play action play. Yeah. That's how it's done, Justin. That's how it's done, Justin. So many play actions. Drizzt. That would have helped him build meter or whatever it's called. And I don't want to say we need a new offensive coordinator, but to keep it real, I want to change playbooks if I thought he was going to block them so that I could slide. Anyway, I think there's a change of playbook is coming, I think. Is that my fault? I think it is. DTR, come on. Shoulder, substitute. It's almost halftime. Come back when you're good, man. Ooh, nasty. All right, we might have to settle for a field goal here, which is fine. I don't want to do a play action. I feel like it's exploiting a mechanic is what it is. I thought that there was a gap for a chase there. I was going to throw a low throw to him. Bunch X nasty? Is that necessary? Why are there so many play actions? I'm gonna call it Omaha. I would have done the same with Trey Lance. Oh, there's a new animation. Area 52's in on it. I was looking for Jamar Chase. I just didn't feel confident with DTR throwing it. I don't think I would have felt confident with Trey Lance throwing it. The coverage was too tight. I was just watching a Bengal, the YouTube content creator, a game where he was in the playoffs with a team with a losing record. He had just gotten shellacked 2 weeks in a row. And then he goes to the playoffs and he destroys that team. It just, sometimes that's just how it happens. Sometimes that's just how it happens. Hey, Trey Lance is back. Here's a smaller dude got brought back. No need to rush it. If we score, we score. If we don't, we don't. We give Eric Gray a carry. It's a draw. He got the first at least. I swear to goodness! We may not be able to get a seventh for him. We may be swapping seventh rounders to move up a little bit. High point, trust you, dude. Keep your number one happy. I'm not saying that from experience. I'm saying that from lack of experience and knowing how that works out. I just don't want to re-sign with you. You don't throw me the ball.
No.
Goons, man. Goons. 53 seconds left. Let's go into our quarters and let's do. Cover one thief. I'll stick with Roby. He's probably going to protect. Inbounds. Good. Call timeout. Cover three spy. Keep a spy on Justin here. No. Oh, triangle. Oh, illegal contact. The guy ran into me. A sack, baby! Call them timeout, boy! 35, they missed a field goal from this distance. Mind you, he doesn't have any picks. He lost a fumble. Oh, they're going for it. Okay. 11-16 Pittsburgh Steelers now. 6 minutes left in the first half. Oh, they still have timeouts. Okay, come on. I'm double clicking the button. Hey, that's one way to get a rushing touchdown, Tony. Tony! Okay, 11-16. Steelers are up. Can't believe I didn't block that kick earlier. That was all me. All right, come on. I saw a pancake and I went in that direction. Yeah, end of the first half. Okay. End of the half. We're probably going to come away with another win. It all started with that fumble, man. 138 rushing yards already. Trey Lance contributing. The London Monarchs, one of our divisional rivals, losing to the Honolulu Steamers. Mac Jones versus CJ Stroud. CJ Stroud having the better of that contest, 83-63. The Redwoods heading to the Columbus Tigers. Columbus Tigers they're both 2-2. The Columbus Tigers are currently shutting them out at half. Tua Tagovailoa, multiple interceptions. And finally, the Salt Lake City Shamrocks, our other rival, losing to the Aviators. Everybody in our division is losing, except Slade. Javian Hawkins, you saw the middle linebacker thought the play was over. Bam. Probably a pass to Jamar Chase. You know what we can do now? We'll do blitz counter. And we'll still contain the scramble just because it's been working. But the reason that we want to switch to blitz counter is because we can do whatever we want at this point. But we really just want to do better when they put pressure on. I really am sick of all these play action stuff. He was supposed to keep running. It's a curl, go. We're going to do a jet sweep. We do one of these a game until we find what is successful. Our right tackle and our tight end have those two. So we're really watching the right outside linebacker here. Well, y'all heard my thought process. I guess another play action in order to keep this. One more clean block. Four rushes, 94 yards from Trey Lance. That's slants again. Nothing wrong with slants. I'm gonna have Pilar block there. He's not a receiver tight end. Oof. I feel like the red just kind of appeared through the player. You know what? Let's throw a run. It's a second and 10, perfect time for a mid drop. And then we'll do a hurry up to keep Gray in there and see what happens. Eric Gray is going to feel that in the morning. We have multiple suits here. Sweep to the weak side. We had just as many blockers when we went to stronger, though. So. All right, let's throw a power play out here. iPhone close, power O to the left. Our guys are strong. All right, they're shutting us down. They're shutting down the run game. They said, they looked at the amount of rushing yards we got in the first half. They said, that's too much.
Access denied.
I guess that's what the difference is, because when our game plan was to run, our blocking was cleaner. Like there, like, why did 81 go up to block zero? They're not making good blocking decisions. Are they tired? We just came out the half. But whatever, we got three. Jake Elliott, my boy. I'm pressing X and I move on with our life. Peace. Wow, I got caught twice on that same defender. Okay, 4th and 11. Elijah Moore with 6 yards receiving on this drive. That's real life. Most likely gonna punt it. Staying in slow. Madden, you can't be that airheaded. If I'm moving to the right and cutting across and he's there, obviously what I'm trying to do is tap it. I just want to be recognized for making the right decision. I was watching where I was going and I heard the smack. I didn't see it. Alright, 3 wide receivers. Linebacker fire 2. Pete Warner on a spy. Trying to move. That was dumb. Do you not know who I am? That was dumb. We haven't done one of these. I'm not very good at these. I should do more of these. Allowed 200 rushing yards. And I doubted our coordinator who said we could do it too. He held on to it! Alright! Zay Jones, I think he's our leading receiver this year in terms of yardage and maybe even touchdowns, although that probably changed with Jamar Chase going off on that first half. Yeah. I'll take it. Well, let's get an update on how things are going in real life football land. Nick Chubb currently carted off the field today. Carted off the field after suffering an apparent knee injury in Monday's matchup with the Browns. He took a helmet to the knee from Steelers safety Minka Fitzpatrick. He was subsequently replaced by Jerome Ford in the backfield. He's already been ruled out for the game. I want to be happy.
Hmm.
Yeah, I'm out here. I was inviting on that wheel route. That's a lot of it. 15 points so far. Work it, baby. Work the magic. Cover three wide receivers. Keep them in front of us. At the beginning of the fourth quarter, we're going to put in our backups. No point getting anybody hurt. Might not even need to if we can outrun these guys. Never mind. Uh, 300 rushing yards on the season after four games. That's almost 100 a game, but remember, he's not the starter. In the first couple of games, we did have Josh Jacobs. And the great part about it was, the game before Josh Jacobs got hurt, we took him out of the game to protect his health. We just put him in way too early, like the beginning of the next game. Whatever, Gray. I can't wait to get rid of you. I'm gonna be so happy. So this is our quick passing concept. Let's go with medium and see what we got. There we go, tight end drive. Look at all these non-play action plays. So Smith and Kalar on the drag, I preferred not to. That is not the route I needed you to run. Johnny was supposed to come across on the flat level. See, that's how you get replaced. All right. I see pressure on the left. Might have the best rushing game by a quarterback ever. You heard what it said. He was helping you up, man. Let him help you up. He was helping you up. I remember Andrew Luck came into the league and he was trying to tell people, hey, good sack, baby. And people are like, that's not how that's supposed to work. The up is clear. And that's the end of the quarter. I'm going to go ahead and do this now. Not Trey Lance, though. I still don't. That's just because I don't like Eric Gray. We'll put Ricard down there. We'll put him. That's fine. Yeah, Jamar will replace with Zay Jones and Austin. Then I wish, man. Freddie Swain should never see the field. I just remembered he's hurt, and that hurts my life. Scoopity-Dorf, get some playing time. Christian Barmore? No, work on your numbers. Do that. Juwan Payne, let's not get you in any danger. Put Austin and Nunez Borges in there, as well as Hurt. Jerry Hughes should be in our depth chart higher than all of this. I totally forgot I had him. I mean, we picked him up and Broncos. They haven't been in the lineup all game? I signed them because of injuries. And they really should have been out there already. Tyus Bowser gets some experience. Devin Lloyd gets some experience. Pete Warner. Man, and I just remembered, too, that Dalton Kincaid was only a few snaps away from uncovering his development. I mean, how did you feel? This happens to everybody. So how did you feel when it happened to you? I want to stop feeling sad. Third down running back, not data. Power? But in that case, yeah, Eric Gray feeling that. I believe that by reordering the depth chart the way I did so that my starters are out, I believe that that puts them in on special teams plays. So they can still get in the field, on the field, and injured. That has happened to me one time where I took out Khalil Mack. I was like, you're done for the day. You did amazing. He was in on one of those plays on a kickoff return. But we kicked off, and he was on the hands team and got injured for the season. That was a secure catch, and he still caught it. Zay Jones is just relentless. He's relentless. I love it. Not gonna lie, I was trying to get Calvin Austin some experience. I'd rather have the points. So in this case, this is where we're going to be careful about who we have on the field. He's number zero? I think a lot of these numbers are wrong. Hello again, Fields. I sniffed it out and I got vacuum blocked. See, now I'm mad. Now I want to hit something hard. With Goku. But get me mad! Looking at me like that. So this is a levels concept more than it is a post concept. I wonder why it's in deep place. I mean, I understand Jonesy for that. You already know what it is. I'm surprised he broke the tackle because that's a superstar. Who's blinking? That should have been picked. That wasn't a strong enough throw. I knew I was going to make it too, and it just what I did. I messed up. That was a tough catch. Oh, it's this. Stick with the buddy concept. More space on this side of the field. So what I'm looking for here is still on tight ends, man. I can't believe that worked. I mean, if anybody can do it, he can do it. Him, Kyle Juszczyk, you know, you think about players like Mike Alstott, utility backs, blocking, catching, they can do it all. I made the sliders to be tougher too. I'm telling you, Justin Fields just doesn't. Him and Lamar Jackson, if you take away what Madden is going to make them do, because it's not them. If they did, I mean, Justin Fields more than Lamar Jackson. But Justin Fields is not a good passer, and he knows that. So he's got to pick and choose his spots, and if they're not open, he's got to run. That's what Madden is going to do. So if we cover them well, then we'll get them into this position where now they're desperate. I went for the slot there. I might have gotten probably a little bit earlier. Once you get the computer into a desperation mode, the world is yours. That's just having fun. All right, Deron Payne. Wow. He stepped out of bounds on his own. Man, they fight a lot. Boca Blitz. Smash Mouth Football right in the Boca. Can I? They're gonna make me earn all of these points, which is fine. I'm willing to do. What a throw! What a throw! Is that Zay again? It's no wonder he's our leading receiver! I'm surprised he doesn't have an X Factor. Fantasy football managers are like, come on, man, look that up. Jamar's not even on the field. I got juked just now. See, like, last season, if you look at, I think, the second game of the Nighthawks franchise, the Cincinnati Bengals faked a punt. Totally got me, and I ended up losing that game big time. Wow, switch me to the other guy, why don't you? Who? Okay, sure. But yeah, they faked on me, and it worked. I bit, and then I lost the game. They can do that from time to time. They can do what a human would do to embarrass. Like, it doesn't always have to be EA. Yeah, come over here. Come over here. Oh, okay. You know what? See? Justin Fields. I covered that outside. If it were Matt Ryan, Andy Dalton, Russell Wilson, they wouldn't have ran it. Cool. Good call. Good call. That was a great call. That was the end. No picks this game. No picks. Ah! It was a good call the first time. It was a good call the second time too, I suppose. He's had a very Justin Fields game. 200 yard passing, 60 yards on the ground. Oh my God! That was it. Lost the fumble. Very Justin Fields game. I smashed that guy. I think the injury is down to like 19. 19! Skip with the door! Substitute. We're there. We don't want to. Yeah. Just recover. 2 minute warning! 2 minute warning. See, special sound effects per team. Dragons and lions would probably get a lot of the same sound effects. Not a lot of opportunity to use it in this game, though. Third and goal. Can we do a stand? Three wide receivers. Okay. Cover flats. Lloyd, go in. Yes! Tyus Bowser! Don't trust him. Safe. That was a high jump. So, I think I'll take this opportunity to talk about what I'm going to be looking for in the draft. We already went over what our top positions are, but if I'm going to get a defensive tackle late, non-starter, development, project, backup, that kind of thing, I want him to have a measurable that makes him worth drafting. I want him to be 400 pounds, or I want him to be 7 foot tall with 98 jump. And then I want to work on his jump until he's 100 years old. I can't believe it. I can't believe it. Get off of me! Ouch. Smacked at the line. Clock's not running though, so I guess that was out of bounds. See, Hawkins getting yardage is great and all for our game. Oh, I thought I almost beat him on that. Let's do a play action cross. I want Austin to get some yards, man. Like, yeah! He reminds me so much of Tavon Austin. Darling from my fantasy football team years and years and years ago, St. Louis Rams. Just set denied. Their interception is normal. I don't know why they're dropping picks. They also have not been dropping passes either. You know, a lot of that only happens to humans. Ooh, that should have been picked twice. Alright, 4th and 15. Run it, get some more yards. Let me get some more yards for Trey. Take them with you. Move Breida. There's still 2 seconds left. Jake Elliott, where are you at? Earn your points, brother. And that's the game, right? 0-0's on the clock. The same losing animation for all the coaches, Brian Daboll included. But yeah, the New York Giants moved to Brazil. And they came all the way back to the States just to lose. 90% completion percentage for Justin Fields. 7 throwing touchdowns for Trey Lance. Did we get a rushing touchdown? One by Jadeveon Hawkins, one by Tony Pollard. But 7 rushing touchdowns. 311 yards through the air, mind you. Justin Fields got 235. No touchdowns, no interceptions. He's only had 2 touchdowns on the year and no picks yet on the season. Okay? DTR came in. 1 completion out of 2 attempts for 50%, 15 yards, no biggie. But in terms of running, 85 yards by Jadeveon Hawkins, 188 by Trey Lance. Eric Gray was in there as well. Dorian Thompson had 6. Love it. And then some negatives, and then Patrick Ricard gets his 1. All I want him to do is soften one person up. He aims, and he... Love it. On their side, Tony Pollard had 23 rushing yards, a 1.9 carry average with 1 touchdown, 44 yards from Justin Fields. We were expecting that to be their game plan. They should have stuck to it. For receiving, let's start with their side. Tony Pollard had more air yards, 83. Not bad. Tyler Boyd, 46. Goddard, 38. Van Jefferson, 36. Garrett Wilson, 32. Zay Jones, 184, 3 touchdowns of the 7 that were thrown today. Jamar Chase, only in for 3 quarters, 79 yards, 2 touchdowns. I didn't want him to get hurt. We saw Patrick Ricard get 2, including a touchdown, 16 yards, 2 catches, 1 touchdown. Calvin Austin came in on the field in that last quarter where I moved everybody up, gave him some experience points, a catch for 23 yards. Remember, he's the one who gave us the electric kick return for a touchdown a couple of games ago. Eric Gray, you're there. Khalil Shakir, you got 1 for 6, and Johnny got 1 for 12. He also had a drop. I remember that. Defensively speaking, Pete Werner with 5 total tackles. Joe Sherbert with 6. No tackle for a loss from you today, Joe. What's up? You sick or something? Devin Lloyd, 6. Javon Holland, 5. Pete Werner, 5. Bradley Rover, 4. Adrian Phillips, 4. Tyus Bowser, 1. Bryce Dallin, 4. Mike Edwards, 4. Deron Payne, 3. They had a lot of plays. We had 2 tackles for a loss from Christian Barmore, 3 from Deron Payne, 2 from Tyus Bowser, 1 from Adrian Phillips, and finally our sack numbers are looking better. 2 from Pete Werner, 1.5 from Christian Barmore and Tyus Bowser, and then Scoopledorf 3, the third, got in there for a sack of his own. No picks. Several forced fumbles. 2 by Adrian Phillips. 2 by Devin Lloyd. one by Javon Holland, and one by Pete Werner. Jake Elliott put in some work today. 9 extra points. Two field goals at 100%. Kavanaugh sent 42 yards on kick return duty and 8 on punt return duty. Fantastic. We had a very nice score. I agree. With that, we do want to give one opportunity. We got all the franchise. We got 26 franchise points there. Love it. Now at 78, we could probably go ahead and spend some. But we do, before we move on, we want to take one more chance to negotiate. Christian Barmore, we're trying not to overpay him. Last off we submitted, good starting point. We're trying to save some money, but we want him. He's 24. Let's put up the bonus and a little bit more on salad. He doesn't like being so far from home. So he's not interested in coming back. He values the financials. So more money. Yeah. And we're winning. But I mean, look at our depth behind him. You know. Come on, man. I would like to play for a new team next year, huh? No. No. Stay with us, Christian. Bye, Eric. Everybody else, bye, 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 bye. We're gonna have, oh wait, Logan Cook, the Cookie Monster, and Jake Elliott, my boy. And we're probably not gonna get a worse deal anywhere else. But I mean, look at the, he wants $14 million for 3 years versus $9 million for 3 years. Right? Am I reading that right? $9 million total over 3 years, five. Plus the bonus. So, can't do it, man. I can't do it. I'd rather draft a picker with a 3-7. Jerry Hughes and Michael Brockers, we picked them up in pre-agent, in the off the waiver wire, just to fill in the meantime. But everybody else can go. $3 million a year is a lot for a punter. We have cap room. We're going to keep it that way. Barmore, you're staying with us. Let's look at some franchise staff stuff. So we did the decreased multi-week injury recovery time. Decrease gains for tight ends. If he's not injured, we might increase on that. Use centers. Found of use, slow ratings progressions, one season for one, I don't need that. XP gains for quarterbacks. XP gains for centers in training. Maybe next year when we draft them. Because we do intend to have the top three pick be a center, cornerback. In fact, I believe our top pick is going to be a cornerback. All right, hands-on offense. Offensive coordinator talents cost less. Defensive cost less. Refund when replacing an offensive coordinator, when replacing a defensive coordinator. Increase the hiring bonus when signing a defensive coordinator. We might want to get these two, mainly because of after school tutoring. Yeah. 2020. Yeah. Yeah, because we intend to replace our defensive coordinator as soon as possible. Two more points and we can get after school tutoring. Let's take a look at the injury report. Not looking forward to it. A month. I mean, we're not the 49ers. We're not the Ravens. We're not the Titans. This is really bad, man. This is why I do this live, too, because I know that men, you're most likely seeing this on YouTube, but I Twitch stream all of these, this whole thing's in its entirety, and I roll with the punches. So next week we're at home against the Redwoods. When is our bye week too? I would love to just have a bye week and get all of our players back. They've got Roquan Smith. Oh goodness. Alright, View Weekly Awards. Did we get any? Trent and Baker from the Caps. Okay. 12 tackles and 2 interceptions. Good God. That's a beast of a game. Yeah, Trey Lance had 7 passing touchdowns and 188 rushing yards. Okay. Sure, I can understand. Now, here's what we're going to do. I'm going to save. That's what I'm going to do. Now, can I talk to Christian Barmore? He's not interested. Okay. I was gonna try to give him an offer, see if he accepted it, and then if not, maybe reload. This is still a game that I'm playing. Look at the news real quick. Is there any way to separate the kind of news? Okay, interception leaders. Bryce Callahan with 4. Gonna pull him Jerome Baker there. Jamar Chase, 4 receptions, 129 yards. Was catching everything today in Salt Lake City. That was from 2 weeks ago. Trey Lance, yeah, we know. Talk about finishing strong. With Jarvis Franklin with over 200 rushing yards in the second half. Is that college? I hope that's college. We gotta be on the lookout for that guy. Offenses will be firing as Snowhawks quarterback Lamar Jackson readies his squad ahead of a date with Kyler Murray's Condors in week 6. Right? Okay, I thought there'd be like college stories and stuff to follow. I guess not. Passing leader, Kyler. Let's take a look at some numbers and then we'll head out for the day. Standings? That's an award. Okay, offense. San Juan Sentinels. Are we the best passing in the league? No, that's the Condors. The Condors are at 1507. We are down at 1340 for passing yards. Alright, passing touchdowns, they have 15. We have 18, and I think a big part of it was because of the 7 from last game. That'll do that to you. Rushing touchdowns, we have 12. We are leading the league in that I'm not surprised. The Black Knights are right behind us with 11, and then we have 2 teams with 10, the Honolulu Steamers and the Columbus Tigers. Points per game, we are currently way good. Sweet. You want me to feel bad? Go ahead, waste your time. Pass yards allowed. The best passing defense in the league is the Montreal Mounties, currently the home of players such as Dudley Do-Right and Rocky Bullwinkle. The Kansas City Riverhawks have allowed 700 yards on the season, pretty good. And we are, apparently we allow rushing yards, or passing yards, because I don't see our names. We've allowed the most passing yards, which makes sense. That people have to fight us to stay in games. All right, the best rushing defense is the Kansas City Riverhawks, who were 2nd, so their defense is immaculate. I'm surprised they're 3-1. League standing 8. That's crazy that they're the 8th seed with the best defense and the 2nd best passing defense. That's incredible. We have allowed very few rushing yards on a game-to-game basis. So I'm proud of that. The best defense in terms of points, the Condors, the Armadillos, the Oilers, the Steamers, and the Aviators. And then we are down there at 83, and we're pretty much sandwiched between the league average at that point. The Condors at 68 points, they just need to meet us. The least amount of sacks, I think this is, this is who's performed the least amount of sacks. So this isn't best in terms of defense. The best sacking defense are the Condors, the Oilers, and the Shamrocks, who did get to us quite a few times. And then the Washington Wizards, the Anchorage Black Knights, and the Honolulu Steamers there. Honolulu Steamers look like they're going to be a problem. Caused the most fumbles, your boy, that's how I play. But then the Desperados, the St. Louis Rams, the Condors and the Black Knights. Condors are going to be a problem. The best interceptions in the league is us, followed by the Caps, Bulls, the Chicago Bulls, the Columbus Tigers, and the City of the Superheroes. I believe on there is Steve Rogers as their quarterback. I know that much. Red zone efficiency, penalties, turnovers. Turnovers, we already looked at that on the offense defense stuff. So, in terms of team stats, I'm pretty proud of us. Let's take a look at the division. So, Kyler Murray has the most passing yards in the league with 1,507. We're behind him with 1,365. And the other conference, Aaron Rodgers and Justin Herbert are both above us with 1,400 and 1,100. Including Andy Holloway, a.k.a. Deshaun Watson, and Inigo Montoya compared to that. So that's Patrick Mahomes, obviously. So we're seeing a lot of good passing numbers all around the league. Trey Lance obviously built a case on the last game. Otherwise, Kyler Murray is one that we have to look out for. The least interceptions by what I'm going to call a starting, like in terms of attempts. Desmond Ridder, 8-1 touchdown interception ratio, really good. 6-1 with Steve Rogers, aforementioned on the Caps. 7-2 Baker Mayfield, 7-2 Inigo Montoya, 9-2 Daniel Jones, and 6-1 Joe Burrow. So names that you expect, at least. Justin Fields, no interceptions on the season because he'd rather run it. And he runs and he fumbles. That's his problem. Best completion percentage in the league, Tyrod Taylor with 1. Oh, man. Here we go. Joe Burrow, 75% on 120. He's the best passer in the league right now. After him, you got Trevor Lawrence and Justin Fields in terms of percentage and not in terms of being good for the team. Average yards per game, Kyler Murray, Aaron Rodgers, Justin Herbert, and then us, Trey Lance. 300 passing yards per game is pretty crazy, though. Let's see if Kyler can keep that up. Yards per attempt, that's us. We are tied with Mitchell Trubisky. and then Joe Burrow there. Joe Burrow's going to be a tough one. He's got 92 for the longest yard, and then Daniel Jones with 94. Derrick Henry leads the league, not surprised. 600 yards in 5 games. That's over 100 per game. That's 120 per game. That's crazy. Jamal Williams, we did play the Snowhawks. He did have a good game against us, and he's currently second in the league with 487 rushing yards. And DeAndre Swift, and then Kevin Dreamweaver. He's the Salt Lake City Shamrock running back, and he was throwing us all which sort of ways, port and starboard. Saquon Barkley, 439, Alvin Kamara, 415, and then Trey Lance with almost 400. More than Bijan Robinson. Haha. All of these guys are lucky that Josh Jacobs is here. Average yards per carry, Darnell Washington with -3, Trey Lance with 12, Patrick Carr with 10, Josh Jacobs with 9.9. That's why I'm telling you that they're lucky. He's only got 29 attempts before he went down. Rushing touchdowns, Ramondre Stevenson with 6, Jamal Williams and Kenneth Walker, and Tony Pollard with 6 as well. He did get one on this last game. Tyler Algier and Yonder Smith all with 6. Javian Hawkins has 5 in his 3 games of work. And then Trey Lance has 4. Very nice. Alvin Kamara with 4. Javonte Williams. Scam Akers. Jeff Wilson Jr. It's good to see a Oiler up here. And Derrick Henry with 4. Derrick Henry is a monster. Broken tackles. See, it doesn't track it the same for everybody. Shrieky O'Heliot with 24 broken tackles. King Hippo with 24. Marty McFly. Oh, that's going to be probably my first YouTube short right there. Just those guys. Leonard Fournette, who was our running back last season with the Oklahoma City Nighthawks, 19 broken tackles. Derrick Henry, I'm going to nickname him the Yeti, and we're going to go with that. And then the longest run on the season belongs to Derrick Henry with 75, Josh Jacobs with 75. Let's go. For the receiving, Zay Jones leading the league in reception yards with 526. Christian Kirk with 493 on my fantasy football squad. In real life, not doing anything. Amon Ross St. Brown, the sun god, 464 for the Virginia Beach Blues. Such a bad. Terrence Marshall, 457. So we've got 450 and above by quite a few. Devontae Smith, Jamar Chase, baby, let's go. Traquan Smith, Michael Thomas, they're all doing work. That's yards. What about average? The deepest people. Rob Silva Anderson for the Golden, the Mexico City Golden Eagles. That's the team that has the, not 5-point bids, the Clickbait Sports with 5-point bids, Scooter Magruder, Brandon Perna, Tom Grassi, and Urinating Tree. All 5 of them are on this team, in addition to having Andy Holloway, Mike Wright, and Jason Bourne. And a couple of others as well. Noah Gray, the Salt Lake City Shamrock tight end, 28 yards per his one reception. Zay Jones, 26.3. Except look at the difference. 20 receptions versus 2. Keep that up, Robbie Chosen. Jamar Chase, 21.3. Trent Sherfield, Christian Kirk, Devin Duvernay, Charlie Jones, Greg Dulcich, Donald Parham. We've got a couple of tight ends on this list. That's really interesting and amazing to see. Including second overall on that. Average yards per game, you take the yards, you take the average, you take games. Devonta Smith, though, he's the most utilized wide receiver in the league. That's what I mean. Calhoun Stimulator? That's one of my fantasy football managers. The entire Salt Lake City Shamrocks, which is one of our rivals, the top 10 skill position players have all been renamed to reflect that of my fantasy football roster. And then, who's that guy? Zay Jones. Yeah, we utilize him quite a bit. Christian Kirk, Amon Ross St. Brown, Terrence Marshall, Jamar Chase. Most touchdowns, Jamar Chase. 9. Christian Kirk, Deontay Johnson, Zay Jones. That's our guy. So we got a few with 5, a couple with 6, but Jamar Chase is the best in the league. We have the best 1-2 punch. We have the Broncos of old. We have the Wes Welker combination. We have the Ryan Fitzpatrick on the Jets. We have the Allen Robinson on the Jaguars. You know, we have the best wide receiver combination in the league. And we take advantage of that. The longest yard, Christian Kirk and Paris Campbell, 94 and 92. And then Darius Slayton with 78. Zay Jones with 75. He's up there. He's getting it. Defense. Who has the most tackles for a loss? T.J. Watt. Very nice with the Desperados. Good pickup, Desperados. Chichena Nwosu has 7, and so does Kool-Aid! And Leonard Williams, D-Town Titans, These are personal shout outs to my fantasy football team. I'm the commissioner of that league. Vita Vea is on here. It's nice to see an old Oklahoma City Nighthawk on here. Daniil Hunter with 6. Cameron Hayward's on here. Mike Parsons, not a surprise. Pete Werner, the first Sentinel on this list. Very, very nice. I don't see many others. Nick Bosa was... Nope, I was thinking of the other Bosa. The other Bosa brother. I was going to say he was out against us when we played that team. Lance Campbell, Wiz. He's Wiz and I'm Boomstick. Aaron Donald. Ogbonia Akuronkwo. Dexter Lawrence. DJ Reader. Hey, Sean Robinson. I thought for a second that was Allen Robinson. I'm like, he's on defense? Or he's just been picked off so many times that he's made enough tackles. Best sacker in the league, Michael Parsons and Aaron Donald. Yeah, that sounds about right. Leonard Williams. D-Town Titans is on here. Kool-Aid! Biff Tannen from the Back to the Future series, if you know. If you know, you know. Quiddipay, TJ Watt making another thing on here. Randy Gregory, Chris Jones, Joey Bosa. That's who was out when we played the Dragons just now. Rashawn Gary. So those are 3.5-4 sack players. The Snowhawk, Kendall Fuller with 3 interceptions on the season, as well as Jerome Baker and Dory Jackson. Zach Cunningham, Jamil Dean, Kyle Duggar, Rudy Ford. Zaire Franklin and Christian Kirksey all have 2, and there's 1 sprinkled throughout everywhere. Forced fumbles, 11, Javon Holland, 5 games this season. Adrian Phillips, 7. Pete Werner with 3, the top 3 on the league. Then we have Kevin Byard and TJ Watt. He caused 1 against us, I remember that. Safety, we do have 1 safety with Joe Sherbert. So, Nwosu, TJ Watt, Kool-Aid, and Chandler all share that with their dark side of brasses. Defensive touchdowns. Tom Brassi! Pete Werner, Dory Jackson, AJ Terrell. This is fun. This is only the first quarter of the season. Kirk Return, we did have Hamilton. Calvin Austin has 5. I'm looking at touchdowns. Only been 2 on the year so far, Antonio Hamilton and Calvin Austin. We have way more yards because we have way more stops. But when it comes to punt returns, I don't think punt returns we have we're probably not up there in average yet. Parker Washington, he only has 1 though. Not good. Antonio Gibson on punt return duty, but doing really well. Antonio Hamilton, he might be a pro bowler. We'll see. Robert Woods, Darius Phillips, Jahmyr Gibbs, and Dante Pettis. Jarvis Landry's still in the league. They put him on return duty, though. That's kind of crazy. Any return touchdowns? No. All right. Well, with that, we've circled around the league. We've already saved. Nothing's changed since the save, so we're out for the night. We've got some things to change. But we've got a lot of things that we're doing right. So we're going to be missing Dalton Kincaid. He's going to have to really claw back from that injury to get that offensive rookie of the year that we've been grooming him for. So hopefully everything works in our favor when he comes back. For now, our focus is on the Sacramento Redwoods. We'll take a look at their roster when we get back next week. Look for this on YouTube. We'll look for the outro. The swipe comes from this way.
Well. Really wish that I could have done more uploads throughout the week, but had some competing priorities, you know. Was invited to go to a school dressed up as a Titans fan and was glad to do it, but that took up a lot more time than I thought I would have. But all that being said, hopefully we can get another game in, not only today, which should be Saturday, but another one up tomorrow. I also have a podcast that I do for my fantasy football league, so hopefully they're enjoying that and they're going to get another one where I just kind of go over my league pick'ems. I don't know if all platforms have it, but I know Yahoo does. And I also go over the good and bad decisions that other people have made. Those are the same league mates that you've seen in my Salt Lake City game on week four. Is that this one? No, this is week five with the Red Dragons, right? Yeah. Whew. Well, let's get week six going as quickly as possible. Again. And nothing. Give a few seconds. Hit my music. See y'all next time.